Good afternoon, everyone. I am Dr. Milind Nemade, professor and head in Department of Electronics Engineering, KJ Somaiya Institute of Engineering and Information Technology, Sion, Mumbai. Today, I am going to present a topic, General Packet Radio Service, which is also called as GPRS. These are the contents of my presentation. What is GPRS? Benefits of GPRS. Comparison of GSM and GPRS. Features of GPRS. GPRS network architecture. GPRS network elements. Data services and classes in GPRS. Disadvantages of GPRS. And finally, applications of GPRS. First topic is, what is GPRS? GPRS is packet-oriented mobile data standard on the 2G and 3G cellular communication networks, GSM communication. So, G stands for general, and general means it is not restricted to GSM use. While PR stands for packet radio, which enable packet mode communication over air. S stand for service, and since GPRS is a service, it is not system. Existing BSS infrastructure is used in GPRS. GPRS is established by European Telecommunication Standards Institute, which is also called as ETSI. The GPRS system is an integrated part of GSM network switching subsystem. GPRS is new bearer service for GSM that greatly improves and simplified wireless access to packet data network. GPRS applies packet radio principle to transfer user data packets in an efficient way between mobile station and external PDN. PDN stand for packet data network. Now let's see the benefits of GPRS. Benefits. First benefits of GPRS is new data services. After some slides, we'll come across this topic in detail. What are the new data services of GPRS? Basically, there are two modes of data services, which we'll see in subsequent slide. Another benefit of GPRS is it is high speed. So data rate from 14.4 to 171.2 kbps is the data rate which falls under high speed category. Efficient use of radio bandwidth. This is possible because of statistical multiplexing is one of the benefit of GPRS. Circuit switching and packet switching can be used in parallel in GPRS. Constant connectivity is one of the biggest benefits of GPRS. Since it is connected very fast, so it feels like it is continuously on. We can also call it as always on. GPRS support many new applications ranging from mobile e-commerce to mobile corporate VPN access. VPN stands for virtual private network access. GPRS allows other services like unicast, multicast, and broadcast services. These are a comparison of GSM and GPRS. On left side of the slide, there are the parameters of comparison. First parameter is technology point of view. GSM comes under 2G and GPRS comes under 2.5G network. Carrier channels for GSM and GPRS having same frequency of 200 kilohertz and support 8 channels. Connection type for GSM, it is circuit switch, and for GPRS, it is circuit switch as well as packet switch. Data rates of GSM is 9.6 kbps, while GPRS it is 14.4 to 171.2 kbps. Frequency separation of both GSM and GPRS is same, at the frequency of 45 megahertz. Modulation used in GSM is 0.3 GMSK, while in GPRS it is GMSK. GMSK stand for Gaussian Minimum Shift Keying Technique. Uplink frequency used for GSM and GPRS is same. Uplink frequency basically used for transmission of information from mobile station to base station, and the frequency is 890 to 915 megahertz. Well, downlink frequency, which is used for transmission from base station to mobile station, it is also same for GSM as well as GPRS, and the frequency band is 935 to 960 megahertz. Frame period for GSM and GPRS is same, which is 4.615 millisecond. SMS, short messaging services, supports 160 characters of text in GSM, while GPRS used as a bearer service and which support multimedia messaging system. Billing in GSM is for duration of connection, while billing in GPRS is for amount of data transfer. Applications of GSMs are mobile telephony, telemetric system for toll connection, while for GPRS it is email, web browsing, broadcast services, and many more. Next point is features of GPRS. GPRS overlays on existing GSM to provide high-speed data services. It is an important step on the path to 3G, which is third generation. GPRS standardized by ITSI, European Telecommunications Standards Institute. GPRS support point-to-point packet transfer service and point-to-multipoint packet service. GPRS support demand-based time slot allocation. GPRS billing based on volume of data transfer. GPRS utilize existing GSM authentication and privacy procedures. GPRS-based network have high bandwidth. This is the GPRS network architecture. GPRS architecture works on the same procedure like GSM network, but has additional entities that allow packet data transmission. This data network overlays a second generation GSM network, providing packet data transport at a rates from 9.6 to 171 kbps. Along with the packet data transport, the GSM network accommodates multiple users to share the same air interface resources concurrently. GPRS include several security services such as authentication, access control, user identity confidentiality, and user information confidentiality. The GPRS architecture introduces two new network elements, which are called GPRS support node, GSN, and are in fact routers. All GSNs are integrated into the standard GSM architecture, and many new interfaces have been defined. The gateway GPRS support node, which is called as GGSN, is the internetworking unit between GPRS network and external packet data networks, which is called as PDN. This node contains routing information for GPRS users, perform address conversion and tunnels data to a user via encapsulation. The GGSN is connected to external networks via GI interface and transfer packets to the HGSN via an IP-based GPRS backbone network, which is also called a GN interface. The other new element in the serving GPRS support node, HGSN, which support the mobile station via GB interface. The HGSN, for example, request user addresses from the GPRS register, which is also called a GR, keeps track of individual mobile stations locations, is responsible for collecting billing information, for example, counting bytes, and perform several security functions such as access control. The HGSN is connected to a BSC base station controller via frame relay and is basically on the same hierarchy level as an MSC, Message Switching Center. The GR, which is typically a part of HLR, Home Location Register, stores all GPRS relevant data. Next, GPRS network elements. There are basically two GPRS network elements. GSN stands for GPRS support node, and GPRS register, which is basically GR. GPRS include two GSN. HGSN stands for serving GSN, and GGSN stands for gateway GSN. HGSN delivers data packets to mobile station and vice versa. It detects and registers new GPRS MS in its serving area. HGSN also performs packet routing, transfer, and mobility management. It also performs authentications, maintaining user profiles. HGSN also performs few functions related to location register, which store location information and user profiles. GGSN interface, GPRS backbone network and external packet data network, converts GPRS packets from HGSN to PDP format. It also converts PDP addresses changed to GSM addresses of the destination user. HGSN store the current HGSN address and profile of the user in its location registers. HGSN perform authentication. It also perform functions like many-to-many relations among HGSNs and GGSNs. GPRS register. GPRS register is integrated with GSM HLR, maintains GPRS subscriber data and routing information. GPRS register also store current HGSN address. Now let's see data services and classes in GPRS. So GPRS support basically two modes of services. One is called as application mode. Another one is tunneling mode. In application mode, GPRS phone user can use the applications running on the device. GPRS phone comprises of WAP browser that enables browsing WAP activities. Few GPRS phones support mobile execution environment to facilitate client applications to be executed on the phone itself. Application mode also supports Java or C or C++ for developing applications. In tunneling mode, GPRS services, GPRS interface can be utilized by the user to access the GPRS network. GPRS phone will be connected to large or small devices like laptop, PDA, tablets, etc. GPRS phones will serve as modem for providing access to wireless data network. A serial cable or PCMCI card can be used for obtaining access. GPRS handset has one of the three classes, class A, class B, or class C. Class A supports GPRS data and GPRS services like voice and short messaging service. In class A, GPRS can receive SMS even if data or voice call is ongoing. In class A, GPRS handset can receive calls simultaneously on two services. In class B, only one service at once. It can monitor GPRS channels simultaneously. When circuit switch traffic exists, the GPRS virtual circuits will be switched to held mode or busy mode. GPRS handset can make or receive call either using switched or packet call types. In class B, GPRS handset can receive SMS even if a data or voice call is ongoing. In class C, GPRS handset can be used to make or receive call manually through the selected service. SMS features is optional for class C. GPRS handset in class C supports only non-simultaneous attach. Now let's see the disadvantages of GPRS. First disadvantage is lower speed. General packet radio service is packets switching technology that enables data transfer to cellular networks. It is used for mobile internet, multimedia messaging service, and other data communications. Theoretically, speed limit of GPRS is 115 kbps, but most of the network, it is around 35 kbps. Second disadvantage is limited cell capacity for user. GPRS does impact a network's existing cell capacity. There are only limited radio resources that can be deployed for different uses. Use for one purpose precludes simultaneous use for another. For example, voice and GPRS calls both use same network resources. Next disadvantage is GPRS result in potential transit delay due to GPRS packets sent to destination. They sent in all different directions so that some of them received properly, some of them lost, or some of them corrupted. Next disadvantage of GPRS is increasing number of user will slow down the service. GPRS core network allow 2G, 3G and WCDMA mobile networks to transmit IP packets to external networks such as internet. So during active call, network related functions cannot be used, and this is one of the disadvantages of GPRS. GPRS does not support store and forward mechanism for SMS. Store and forward is a data communication technique in which a message transmitted from a source node is stored at an intermediary device before being forwarded to the destination node. Now let's see the applications of GPRS. First application is internet access for accessing corporate data, educational data, and service information. The internet is an effective tool, and it is one of the applications of GPRS. Next application is intranet service. The user can maintain contact with their offices through emails, fax, and voicemails using unified messaging system. Third application is email and fax, as we all are aware of email and fax systems. Next application is business conducted on internet, which is also called as e-commerce. Next is banking applications. Electronic banking or wireless connection supports features like checking the balance, transferring money to an account, paying the bills, overdraft alert, creating recurring and fixed deposit, etc. All the banking services, which is one of the application of GPRS. Next application is stock exchange over internet. And then advertising. Advertising is one of the main important application of GPRS for buying and selling different consumer products. Advertising media is used. Next application is location-based services and telematics. So where user within his location finding nearby hotels, restaurants, shops, get roadside assistance, vehicle tracking, workforce management, and fleet management, etc. are location-based services in GPRS. So next application is chat. People use different chat services through internet and through SMS. Next one is multimedia services. It includes sending and receiving images, postcard, presentation, advertising, advertisement, greeting cards, or mobile networks. This is also one of the application of GPRS. And finally, virtual private network. GPRS use VPN services for ensuring secure data transfer. So that's all for this presentation. Thank you.